extend a special welcome to our administrators, parents, and guests. I'm Ms. Carson, and my co-sponsor, Ms. Misha, is in the back with our new inductees who are excited to be inducted this evening. A little bit about National Honor Society as we get started. National Honor Society was founded in 1921 by Edward Reinerson and the National Association of Secondary School Principals, with the hope that it would be an organization that recognizes and encourages academic achievement while developing other characteristics essential to citizens in a democracy. This prestigious organization ranks high among administrators, faculty members, students, parents, and residents of the school community. Its reputation for excellence is the result of years of work on the part of everyone involved. Membership is both an honor and commitment. Today, there are more than 12,500 chartered chapters. The local chapter here, we're growing strong, and activities that we do include service projects, teacher appreciation awards, fundraisers that we do annually. Last year, our National Honor Society awarded scholarships to deserving members. We were fortunate enough that our scholarships totaled more than $2,000 that went to two seniors who were the National Honor Society. National Honor Society is a leader among organizations and societies that promote appropriate recognition for students to reflect outstanding accomplishments in the areas of scholarship, character, leadership, and service. It is through the efforts of our membership that NHS maintains its high standards for the benefit of all society. It is with great pleasure that we induct these special young men and women into the New Haiti chapter of National Honor Society.
Ladies and gentlemen, on behalf of the members and officers of the New Haiti chapters of the National Honor Society, we welcome you to the 2018-2019 induction ceremony. Please stand as our inductees are escorted to their seats. We would like to welcome you to this year's induction of new members to the New Haiti chapter of the National Honor Society. This is a proud and happy occasion, and we are glad that you could be here to share with us. At this time, would you please stand as our JROTC presents the flag for our pledges.
Now the Pledge of Allegiance.
Raise arms.
the Texas flag, I pledge allegiance to the Texas, one state under God, one indivisible.
Okay, please be seated. Tonight, we will be honoring over 40 of the brightest young students in Wheeling High School as we induct a new generation of National Honor Society members. National Honor Society is founded upon the principles of scholarship, leadership, service, and character. Inductees, in all of your undertakings, may you always keep in mind these guiding principles. The emblem of the National Honor Society is represented by the flaming torch and keystone. The flaming torch symbolizes knowledge. The torch, from the earliest of times, has been the emblem of knowledge. Not lighted, it has no power to lead and guide. It has no effect until the torch of a match ignites it with a vital and beautiful flame. The keystone locks together the four qualities held high in the esteem of the National Honor Society. These qualities are character, scholarship, leadership, and service. In keeping with this emblem, the motto of the society is, light is a symbol of truth. I will now light the candle of knowledge and truth. The membership of these inductees into the National Honor Society has been earned by the effective demonstration of the five qualities held in high esteem by the society: scholarship, service, leadership, and character. The officers will now review these qualities for the candidates.
Scholarship means a commitment to learning. Knowing the lasting benefits of a cultivated mind, we must continue to learn even when formal schooling has ended, for education ends only with life. Knowledge is one great element in life which leads to the highest success, and it can be acquired in only one way, through diligence and effort. Learning furnishes the lamp by which we read the past and light which illuminates the future. New members, you are charged to continually expand your world through the opportunities inherent in scholarship.
Leadership exerts a wholesome influence on the school. In taking initiative in classes and in school activities, a real leader strives to train and lead others to obtain the same objective. The price of leadership is a sacrifice, the willingness to yield one's personal interest for the interest of others. A leader has self-confidence and will go forward when others hesitate. No matter what power and resources may exist in a country, they are ineffectual without the guidance of a wise leader. A wise leader is always leading. Thus, to lead is an important charge to each individual member.
Takes all these qualities and hold them forever before the school as goals towards which all should strive for is the purpose of this society. Our aim shall be to hold before the school scholarly habits, to engage in worthwhile service to others, and to lead forward in all things that shall advance the excellence of this school. The candidates will now take part in the candle lighting ceremony. Candidates, please rise. I wish to remind the new inductees that membership in the National Honor Society is one of the highest honors that can be awarded to a high school student because it gives practical meaning to the society's goals of scholarship, leadership, service, and character. Therefore, we light the candles which symbolize the spirit of National Honor Society, the spirit of knowledge and life. Candidates, please recite the pledge with me. Okay. Being aware of the honor which is being bestowed upon me by the selection of membership in the National Honor Society, I do hereby pledge my loyalty to this organization. It shall be an earnest purpose to give sparingly of my time and energy to the promotion of all school activities. I will strive to be, at all times, a model student and will never knowingly bring reproach upon my school. I pledge myself to uphold the high purpose of the society for which I have been selected, striving in every way by word and deed to make its ideals the ideals of my school and my life. Will you now blow out your candles? Please be seated. At this time, Mr. Lay Candle will come forward and help with the presentation of the certificates. Upon receiving the certificate of membership, our new members will sign their name into our record of membership. I wish to say in advance, if I mispronounce your name, I am so sorry, I do no offense. Chris Brown.
Tyler
Brielle Resendez. Thank you to our principal, Ms. Shirley Cano, our sponsors, Ms. Misha and Ms. Carson, and our current members. And congratulations to the new members of the National Honor Society. Hold high the torch. You did not light it to blow. 'Twas given to you by the hand. You know. Is yours to keep it burning bright. You are to pass on when you no more need light. For there are other feet that we must guide, and other forms go marching by our side. Their eyes are watching every tear and smile, and and efforts which you think not worth the while, may be, perhaps, the very things they need, actions to which their souls will take most heed, so that in turn they'll hold it high and say, I say to another, carry this way. In closing, I would like to congratulate the new members of NCHS Honor Society again, as well as the present members who have worked hard to make our organization a success. Remember, the National Honor Society is not a one-person membership, but requires the full cooperation of you to give it your best. Again, congratulations on this great honor. Our ceremony is now concluded.